Hello, I'm Javis Lewis, and in this episode I'm going to show you how to use reference images in DAZ Studio. And that's something that's not really built into DAZ Studio, it's not something that we can easily select, but with a little trick we can use the same principle that we use in Blender, namely creating a plane primitive, projecting an image on it, scaling the plane primitive up properly, and then looking at it from the front in a separate viewport. Let me know what I mean by that. So in DAZ Studio, we head over to Create, New Primitive, and then we go and select a plane primitive. The size can just be 1 meter with a division of 1, but what is important is the primary axis. I believe usually it comes in with the Y positive, and that means the plane is going to lie flat on the ground. So that's good for kind of faking flaws in a portrait image or something. But if we use Z as the positive value, then the plane is going to come in like that, already rotated properly, and that's kind of what we need. So let's select Z positive and hit accept. And that is what we see, a square image which we can rotate around, and that's exactly what we need there. It's already rotated properly, so all we need to do is project an image and resize it properly. And we do that by selecting this either in the viewport or in the scene tab. And with that done, we head over to the surfaces tab here. And on the surfaces tab, well, this kind of depends if you're using DAZ Studio 4.10 or below, or DAZ Studio 4.11 and above, because in DAZ Studio 4.11, one of the changes is that if you create a primitive object, then the surface properties are already set up to use the Iray rendering engine. As of 4.10 and below, these are set up to use the 3D Light surface properties. So right now, because I'm in 4.10, I can see general, diffuse, specular, and so forth. Whereas when I'm in 4.11, I will see general and some other values here. So in order to convert that, if you're in 4.10, it doesn't really matter. You can just head over to the diffuse tab here and then select this little icon to browse to an image of your choice. But if you were in 4.11, then you can, or if you're in 4.10, you want to convert it to Iray, you just select the plane, head over to presets, and in here under shaders you select Iray, and there's the Iray Uber base. So if you double click that, then nothing appears to happen, but as soon as we head back to the editor, then I can see that these properties have all changed for my plane. So if you're in 4.11 or you converted your primitive, then under base you've got this little icon here, and you can use that to browse to your image. Either way, it'll work fine. Hit browse and pick an image of your choice. So I'm going to use this one here. And click OK, and there it is. It's now on my plane, displayed, well, slightly skewed. So it's not really what I want, but that's easy to fix. So for the aspect ratio to be adjusted to that image, we need to know the pixel dimensions, or at least the aspect ratio of the image. So if we know the aspect ratio, and in my case I do know it, it's 16:9, then I can just divide 16:9, and then I'll end up with something like a fraction value. So in this case it'll be 1.7777, which means I can kind of type that value into my X scale value and then scale the image up. So with the plane selected on the parameters tab, I can now go into the scale option here, and looking at the red arrow, that's the one that we need to kind of stretch. You can eyeball it if you want, you can just do that, but if you're kind of a belt and braces type of guy, you can just type in, well, sorry, if you do that, by the way, then you will see which value changes, so by that you can tell what value you need to adjust. So in my case, that needs to read 177 will be fine. I do that, and then my image will be scaled properly to 16:9. I can also, if I'm too lazy to do that calculation, which some of us are, I totally understand that, you can just more or less type in the exact pixel dimensions into the X and the Y axis, so Y is green. So I could also alternatively go and say X is 1920, which is the pixel dimensions of the width. And then that's a bit, you know, stretched here. But then into the Y, I can literally type in 1080. And then, well, I get a really zoomed in image because the image is now extremely large. And that's fine because now I can use the overall slider to adjust it to what I need it to be. That's kind of an interesting, easy way to just, you know, not do that calculation if I don't have a calculator handy or my brain's a little bit tired and one of those things. Now, you'll ask, how am I going to figure out the exact pixel sizes of my image? Well, it's fairly easy. Windows and Mac both tell you how to do that. I'm on a Windows system right now, and if I open up my image here, then I can go and right click on the image in question, and there under the bottom there's properties here, and if I select that, then I can see that on the details tab I will see the under image, I can see what the actual dimensions are. There's other ways of doing it on Windows. There's, if you double tap, then your Photos application opens, and in that you can then right click on the image and then just go and select File Info on that, and that will bring up a similar dialog in which then on the left hand side you will see the dimensions of your image. On a Mac, it's very similar. You just go and right click in a Finder window and you select Get Info, and that'll bring up a similar dialog to show you how big your image actually is. Now, with that out of the way, you have a reference image, but how do you use that side by side with something that you'd actually like to do? So perhaps you have a pose from a real life picture and you'd like to adjust the 3D character to that, or you're matching a shader from a 3D Delight render to an actual iRay preview or something like that. So the way to do that, then, to display these things side by side in DAZ Studio, is to head over to the Window tab. And under viewports, you can choose many of these options. So side by side is one that you can have one full viewport on the left and another one on the right. For reference images, I would prefer to do something like two on the right and one on the left. Or you can even have three on the right and one on the left. So let's do this one here, two on the right and one on the left. And if you do that, then you see something like that. And this is already almost what I want. I can click any of these tabs to close that all down, and then I get my reference image here, and that is where I can choose any of these either orthographic views or any of your cameras that you've set up. Now, the way our reference image is set up, it'd look really handsome if we just look at the front there. If you look at the back, then you'll see the image reversed. That's not really what we want, but if you look at the front, then you look right at that primitive that we've created here, and because there's no geometric distortion in here, you can just size that up and then use the regular shortcut keys to zoom in and zoom out. And if you put something in front of it, like a character, you can size that up exactly as you need it. You can also, back in the perspective view, you can of course position this image as you need it. So maybe you need to position the image slightly bigger or smaller, higher or lower, more left or more right, in front or in the back of your character, so that you get your modeling done properly. So all that is possible, and once you've done that, adjust the front view accordingly, and that's how you have your reference image there. You can go one step further and then create another plane and then angle that here on the left or on the right, and then just angle that by 90 degrees, and then you can create reference images from all sides if you need that. It's my quick tip today in DAZ Studio. Join me again for another live stream on Friday, in which we're doing some scene building. I'm doing those every Friday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'm also coming out with more episodes for the DAZ Studio 101 series once every week. Join me for that if you will. I will see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.